Hello everyone! We just got back from the Essen Fair, as you can see, and a lot of people have contacted us to tell us there's so much stuff in the box, they're struggling with putting everything in the right package. So we decided to make a quick video today. It's not highly polished, but we just want to help you get it sorted and you can get into the game quickly. So I hope that helps you. Okay, we first obviously start by unwrapping the box. You have the rule books, the stickers, which you can use later, clan board, and the rondelle. So, and now comes the interesting stuff. I would suggest that you first take the Chronicle boxes and assemble them. There are 8 of them. So, it's pretty easy to do. Check. Chronicle 1, Dragon Boat Races, so now that you have the Chronicle boxes, I'll show you some of the components. We have the stack of cards, we have the boats, we have the mountain, and from your meeples you can take out the black meeple, hiding somewhere in between. So what you currently can leave in the box are all the other meeples. You have the cows, the sheep, the barley, the stone, the whiskey casks, the wood, and the 2-player die. A lot of zip bags, which you might want to use. These you're probably fine with, you just sort them in, as you can see in the inlay at the bottom, where there's space for the resources. So, put them over here. And we start by opening the tiles. And that's a lot of material. I understand you can get confused here. So let's start with the ones. These are the basic tiles for the game and all the chronicles, and they are sorted in which stack they belong with A, B, C, D on the back. So if we take the first one, I can show you that these up here belong to the base game because they don't have a chronicle symbol like some of these down here have. So the chronicle symbol here, the whiskey and the boat race and the haggis, so on, you see that these are chronicle content. Where do you find that information? If you take a look at the rule book, they are the rules for all the chronicles, and you find the corresponding symbol up here. So you know all the stuff that contains bears that symbol, it's from Chronicle 7. And if we start compiling these now, we can start with, for example, Chronicle 1, the boat race, Chronicle 2, there can only be one, the Highlander, and so on. Here we also list the contents which are included in this chronicle, so you can find the information here together with a picture of the material. But that's what we run through now, so you can just follow the video. Okay, so we start by punching out all the 8 tiles. This one is a bit smeared. If you have any material that is not perfect, let us know. We will send you a replacement. In some games that happens. So, and now we can look at the font sides. And you see that all the tiles that don't have a chronicle symbol, like these, belong to the base game. And these are all A stack. So you can put these into the box where it says ABCD and tuck them away. Now the other ones we sort by symbol. So we have these haggis tiles. They are from one of the chronicles, the boat race, the whiskey, the Englishman, another whiskey tile, and we have the dubious tome of Scottish history. You can now do that with all the additional tiles. You can make it thicker here. These are the B-stack tiles, which you can put into the base game. And the other ones are sorted according to the symbol again. We have another Hammer of the Scots, the boat race. This is the only tile that bears the symbol in the lower left corner for reasons of making it too close to the other symbols here. Where's my whiskey? Here. So, and we do the same for the C and D stack. On this sheet, there are the player starting pieces. Can see we filled some of the stuff here already. The player starting pieces go here in the box. And in case you have the 9th promo chronicle, there's space for it here as well. That's one of the boxes that fits in here. In addition, there are 5 S tiles, the starting tiles, which are shuffled at the beginning of the game and are the first 5 tiles you can play with. They are also placed here. And we have another B stack. As you can see, it features a chronicle icon, so this goes to the boat race. And these 2 boat race non-player areas, if you play with two or three players, you can add them to the boat race. They fit nicely in here with the resources. So now we can punch out these things. First, if you start with this one, there are the nay and ay markers here. They belong to the chronicle Between a Rock and a Hard Place, as you can see in the rule book. So we punch them out. You can use obviously one of the zip bags if you like. So the A and N markers go into Between a Rock and a Hard Place. There are these tokens with a +1 and -1. Also, as you can see in the rule book, these are used in Chronicle number 8, the Penny Mobs. So we punch them out. And put those into the penny mobs. The rest of those are the gold coins and the victory points, which just go into the base game. So you have the 1, 3, 5, 10, and 50 victory point tokens. I leave them in here. I think you'll find your way around. Then we continue with these. These are the Haggis tokens. And they belong into the chronicle number 5, Address to a Haggis. If you like, you use your Ziploc. And stow it away. The bonus tokens here are for the boat race in Chronicle 1. Put them in here. Then there's the Englishman token and the English market row. These go into Hammer of the Scots, number 4. I already mentioned it, you can find the information what material belongs to which chronicle in the rulebook if you're unsure, so take a glance there. Now a lot of people asked us, these 4 shields, they don't belong to any chronicle, where are they going? And I have to say, you can't know because it was a last minute decision to produce them, because we had 4 spaces left here, but the rules were already printed. So we decided that for the 4 ongoing effects, like MacGregor, Sinclair, McIntosh, and MacLachlan, to put reminder markers into the box. So if you activate this clan field, you get an ongoing effect. You can place this in your play area so you remember it if it's your turn, that you have a special effect going on. Sorry that we didn't include it in the rules, but we thought it was a nice idea to do it anyway. Then for the last cardboard pieces, these brown ones, these go to the Chronicle number 8, the Penny Mobs. They are placed on cards. And if you use the ability of a penny mob, you can remove one of the tokens or place it somewhere according to the rules. So these go into the penny mobs. The only remaining pieces here are the clan board markers that you use to put on your clan board in your player color. These are part of the base game. I leave them in the on the board. So now it boiled down to not too much more. Them here. The boats belong to the boat race. This beautiful little mountain belongs to There Can Only Be One, and this is the only content of this chronicle, so you can just tuck it in here and that one's finished. You have the Hammer of the Scots Englishman, obviously going into Hammer of the box, and the last stuff we have are the cards. These are pretty easy to sort. From the top, you have the 11 landmark cards that are part of the base game. And as you can see, they don't have a chronicle symbol. So you can put them in the base game box. These go in here. Here I can put the resources now here in this area, so we have a bit more space. This is where the cards go, and we also put the die here. And the remaining few things here, these are for the chronicle. We can put the boxes in at the end. I'll show you that later. So, these other cards feature chronicle symbols. So you already know now where they go. It's the Hammer of the Scots expansion here. We have the Whiskey Chronicle, Old Jamie's Single Cask Reserve. These go with the whiskey tiles. We have the Penny Mobs. And you see, the first one of these, they feature the Penny Mob symbol. And there are a number of cards that feature the Penny Mobs and another chronicle symbol, like the Boat Race. Because if you play with the Penny Mobs and the Boat Race, you add these cards. But leave all of them in the Penny Mobs box, and you just take them out if you are playing with more than one chronicle. So, I believe the Penny Mobs are done. Here, the boat race symbol, as you can see in the lower right. So here with the boat race. Here we have the symbol of the Dubious Tome of Scottish History. and also some replacements if you play with the Dubious Tome of Scottish History and the Hammer of the Scots expansion. We exchange the landmark cards there. So this is the content of this. And here, between a rock and a hard place, it's these 10 cards, and these are for the Haggis expansion. So, between a rock and a hard place cards, to the eye and name markers. Put them in the box now. The Dubious Tome of Scottish History. As you see, this is a big one, because of all the replacement cards. Because if you use these landmarks, you replace the ones from the base game, because these have this painted backside with the artwork on it. You find all that in the rulebook. Six. Address to a Haggis. Put the additional Haggis material in. We have the Hammer of the Scots expansion. Number 4. Old Jamie's single cask reserve with replacement tiles for all the distilleries of the base game. And the cards. Number 2 is already packed with mountains, and the last one is the boat race. Put the boats in there as well. I should have put the cards on the other side. That's a bit easier to close. And the shield tokens, you can best sort them in here because there's a space left next to the cards. And this is basically it. So, you have your fully sorted box. And to there's one remaining question some people ask. We have 4 stickers. And they don't know what they're used for because we didn't tell you. These go to the onto the Englishman meeple, if you like, the black little meeple. And these are just redundants. If you have any remaining questions, please don't hesitate and contact us. You can write us an email, info@funtails.de, or contact us via Facebook or Twitter. And yeah, we will try to get back to you as soon as possible. Have fun playing the game. Bye bye.